In the 1950s, the French Air Force and aviation industry were looking for new solutions to improve the combat capabilities and combat stability of tactical aviation. The most interesting and promising development was considered to be the creation of short or vertical takeoff and landing aircraft. The Dassault Balzac V experimental aircraft was the first example. Such a plane could handle all sorts of missions and didn't need a long runway. The concept of vertical takeoff and landing, or VTOL aircraft, was developed by the Dassault Group. On the Mirage 3, the experts used the main engine Snake Mach with a thrust of 88 kN and Rolls-Royce lifting engines of 24 kN each. However, the test engine did not produce the expected results, and Dassault had to adjust its plans. The Mirage 3 Snake Mach Anta G2 propulsion engine was replaced with a non-afterburning Bristol C-delay Orpheus with a thrust of 21.57 kN. The lift engines were grouped in tandem pairs around the aircraft's center of gravity on either side of the propulsion engine's intake duct, with each pair in a row separated by the main undercarriage wheel base. To save costs, the new vertical takeoff aircraft was built on the prototype of the Mirage 3001. Later, the experimental project was named the Mirage Balzac V. According to the concept of the project, the Mirage Balzac V was a tailless, low-mounted wing aircraft, similar in appearance to other aircraft in the Mirage fighter family. To install the lift engine, the fuselage had to be rearranged to increase the area of the center part of the fuselage. The air intakes were located above the fuselage, covered with movable flaps. To control in-level flight, they retained the standard cable and rigid wiring from the Mirage 3. Balzac V had a length of 13.1 meters, wingspan of 7.3 meters, height of 4.6 meters. It had an empty weight of 6.1 tons and a maximum takeoff weight of 7 tons. By design, the Balzac V could reach a maximum speed of Mach 2. In the tests, it only reached 1,100 kilometers per hour. To perform takeoff, the pilot had to start the main engine, after which the lifting engines were started using compressed air. By increasing the thrust of the lifting unit, the aircraft had to rise to a height of at least 30 meters, and then horizontal acceleration was allowed. At a speed of 300 kilometers per hour, it was possible to retract the chassis and turn off the lifting motors. project Mirage Balzac V was ready by the end of 1961. In January 1962, a prototype began being assembled at the Dassault plant. The aircraft was ready in May, and the first ground tests were conducted in July. On October 12, 1962, the first takeoff took place at Milan Villaros Airport. The flights resumed early in March 1963 with flight tests of horizontal takeoff and landings. On March 18, a vertical takeoff was performed for the first time, followed by a transition to horizontal flight and landing like a normal airplane. On January 10, 1964, in a test, the plane capsized and crashed, killing the pilot. Undeterred, they decided to restore the damaged plane, which took about a year. On February 2, 1965, test flights resumed. Over the following months, another 65 flights were met with vertical and horizontal takeoff and landing methods. On October 8, 1965, another test flight took place with US pilot Philip Neal. While taking off vertically at an altitude of approximately 50 meters, the plane suddenly lost control and began to fall. The pilot tried to escape, but the parachute was not high enough to deploy. He was killed, and the plane was severely damaged. Despite crashes, two pilots killed and the prototype damaged, the Mirage Balzac V project was still recognized as a success. However, the Balzac V was not developed further, but contributed to the experience of the French fighter industry. My video about Dassault Balzac V answer. Thank you for watching. If you find this video interesting, please give me your thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to support the channel. Goodbye and see you again in the next videos.